This is the Adulting with ADHD podcast, self-empowerment for people with ADHD. Today, I'm very excited to have with me life coach Linda Rogley. And did I get that right?
Yes, you did. Congratulations.
All right. Thank you.
So many people do not.
And we're going to talk a little bit about what she's about, the AD Diva Network and the ADHD Women's Palooza. Hi, Linda. Wonderful to meet you and see you. How's it going?
It's so great to be here. Thank you so much for inviting me, Sarah. I'm thrilled that there's so much support for ADHD, and what yours is one of the best.
Oh, thanks. Yeah. So why don't you tell me a little bit about, first the work you do, and then I know you have a lot of projects going on. I'd love to hear about what you got.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to kind of rewind to the very beginning of the AD Diva Network, because I was diagnosed when I was at perimenopause, like in my mid-40s, late 40s, actually. I didn't believe the diagnosis. It took me three different doctors for me to actually believe it, with some space in between those. But when I started going to ADHD conferences like ADA and CHAD, I was so hungry to talk to other women with ADHD, but there just wasn't much time. Like, there might be like a little breakout session so you could talk to them, or a special whatever. I mean, there was just a very, very little time. And because there was so much going on, let me just make sure that I have my mail turned off so we don't hear any more dings. Sorry about that.
No problem.
And so I was so eager to talk to other ADHD women to find out if they felt the way I did. And there wasn't much out there. Sari Solden had written the seminal book about ADHD. Terry Matlin had written a book about strategies for ADHD women, and that was pretty much it. And to me, they were just kind of like the goddesses of ADHD. And so I was more than surprised when I sat down next to one of them at a conference, and they were really nice to me. And I didn't know them at all. So it was really wonderful, which says a lot about ADHD. I realized that I really wanted to create a network for women that would allow us to talk to each other and give us support specific to women. And both Terry and Sari were doing that, but I wanted to do it in a little different way, because I know your audience and you are probably completely familiar with Dr. Russell Barkley. And I love this man to pieces. He has done the work that has set the stage for us for ADHD to be taken seriously.
Right.
But often when I would come away from one of his lectures at one of these conferences, I felt like I wanted to slip my wrists. All the news was bad.
Yes.
No, it was like, oh my God, we have more car accidents. We have more friend-wounded pregnant. It's just like, oh my God, is there anything good about us?
Yeah.
And I reframed ADHD in a more positive light. And I know that Ned Halliwell does that too. He does it in a little different way, but I wanted to do it for women.
Yeah.
So I actually have t-shirts printed that have the definition of AD Diva, which is the name of what I call us women, that were like impulsive. Instead of impulsive, we're spontaneous.
Oh.
And instead of, conditioned, hyper-focused, we're passionate. So I reframed all of those things.
Oh, cool.
So I wanted to do this in a positive light. And yet I didn't want to be Pollyanna about it. I mean, there's a lot of stuff about ADHD that is no fun.
Right.
So the programs that I ended up setting up through the AD Diva Network related back to my training as an ADHD coach and a life coach, because I trained as a spiritual life coach with Neil Donald Walsh, who wrote the books Conversations with God. And I just want to say, this is not about religion. This is about spirituality. There's a combination, but there's also a specificity that separates them in some instances.
Yeah.
And I thought, how am I going to pull this all together? What I did was create, first I did just private coaching, but I wanted to do women's retreats. And that was my passion.
Oh, yeah.
So from 2005, I've been hosting women's retreats, first not for ADHD folks, but just for spiritual life. And then within a few years for ADHD women as well. And so that was kind of my entree into the world, if you will, and I'd always wanted to write a book. I'd written a couple of books, but they were for someone else. Someone said, write this book. And so I did. I wrote the book, and that was fine. But I wanted to write the ADHD book. And so it took me, not surprisingly, it took me about 4 or 5 years to finally get it going.
Right.
It was finally published. Confessions of an AD Diva, Midlife in the Nonlinear Lane, was specific to women who are 40 and better, as I like to call them. And I was so honored to be named the winner of the first prize for women's issues in the Independent Book Awards the year that the book came out.
Wow.
So I was really, really thrilled about that. So now, kind of fast forwarding to the present, I'm still conducting women's retreats, not last year because, you know, COVID.
Yeah. Yeah.
And this year, I'm so happy to say that I've just booked the beach houses so that we will be able to have a beach retreat. And we also, I also have retreats at my own retreat center, which is kind of kitty corner behind my house. We have about 10 acres of, you know, beautiful verdant North Carolina forest. And so we have retreats here. And I'm actually going to do a virtual retreat in toward the end of April, around my birthday, which is at the end of April. So lots of things going on, plus the coaching spa. The coaching spa is group coaching. I'm still doing some private coaching, and group coaching has just exploded. And they're small groups. And finally, about a year ago, before I really knew anything was going to happen with this COVID thing, I decided I wanted to get organized, and I wanted to invite some friends to get organized with me. So I created the Get Organized program. And it was right after I did a webinar for Attitude Magazine about organizing.
Okay.
I had 85 people sign up.
Oh, geez. That's wonderful. Many
more people than I expected. Then I realized, nope, people weren't done in 4 weeks. So we had to create a follow-up program. So now we have Get Organized and Go Forward. And some people have been in the programs for a year, which doesn't mean that the program doesn't work.
Right.
It means that they're still working on new things. So now I'm really thrilled. And then of course we have the Palooza, which I'm assuming we're going to talk about that a little bit too, but we'll talk about that whenever you want to.
Absolutely. I was curious. The Palooza has always been virtual, right?
It has. Yes.
It
always.
Has. Yeah. Yes. Very interesting. So that's coming up. I was really surprised to see that in my social media feed, because I kept thinking it was far off, and it's here.
It is.
What got you excited about launching that? What was the story behind that program?
Well, in very much the same way that I'd always wanted to write a book and I'd always wanted to do women's retreats, I really felt that I had a vision when I created the ADD Diva Network that I wanted to create not just a conference for ADHD, but a conference for women's ADHD. And I had this, I don't know, there was something in my brain that said it was going to happen in São Paulo, Brazil. I don't know. It was just one of those weird, you know, brain fluke kind of things. And yet what I realized is, because I sat on the board for ADD as vice president for several years, and what I realized is that in-person conferences, number one, have declined since 9/11. The attendance has not been as great as it had been before then. And I know that seems like a long time ago, but it has influenced it even to this day. And they're very expensive because there's a lot of overhead. And I thought, I can't afford to go in there and lose thousands and thousands of dollars. I want to be in front of someone and look into their eyes and say, I get it, and you get it, and we're here, you know, like right here.
Yeah.
Yet I thought, let me just, some of the people who had started virtual conferences had kind of fallen by the wayside. They had dropped out. So I thought, well, there's an opening. Let me step into it. And what my intention was in that first year, which was 2016, was to bring together the cream of the crop experts. I'm talking about the names that everyone knows, like Russell Barkley, like Ned Halliwell, like Tom Brown, Stephen Henshaw, the people who have done the research, the people who really know this inside and out, to the extent that they can, because frankly, even now, there's not a lot of research about women's specific ADHD, and or even girls for that matter. So that was my intention. And I can't tell you how thrilled I was that they even took my call.
So I bet. That's exciting.
It's like, oh my gosh, that person knows me. Well, they may not have known me, but they at least agreed to be part of the Palooza. So we were thrilled to have the Sari Soldans of the world, and Terry Matlin and I created this together. Yeah. And a year or so later, Terry's life got really, really busy. So she has taken a back seat to managing this, even though I still consider her an integral part of it. She was part of the original work. So my goal with that Palooza, and I can't believe this is going to be our sixth year. It just kind of blows me away. But my goal has always been to provide accurate and the most recent information that we can possibly bring to women. And just before we started recording today, we discussed the fact that there's not really a lot of new stuff happening out there. You know, there's still basically two stimulant medications, you know, I mean, it's this progress is slow kind of thing. And yet there are some new things that happen. So my commitment is to bring as diverse a number of experts as possible with a diverse experience and information. And I try very hard to try to not duplicate the information that we had last year. So since we do 30 a year, 30 sessions a year, that makes it really hard to not duplicate what's happened before. But this year we have done that. We have information out there this year that no one's talked about. So I'm excited about that, but it gets a little harder every year to find the experts who know that stuff. Like, for instance, it's been really hard for me to find someone to talk about nutrition and ADHD.
Yes.
I just got an email today from somebody who's doing a class about exactly that. She has ADHD herself. So anyway, wonderful. You open it up and the universe provides, right?
Yes. I want to be on the list for that webinar. Yeah, it's a perfect example of a conversation that a lot of us are craving more information on. I think that's a perfect example. Anything like that this year that you're just like super jazzed to see as far as speakers?
Yeah, well, there are a couple of things that we've not talked about at all. I mean, we do talk, there's some relationship seminars, there's yes. relationships topics, you know, with some of the people I've had on before and some new folks, which is mm-hmm. also what I try to do is have a variety of folks. So some of the folks you saw last year, you may not see this year, but you might see them next year. We hope we have another next year. One of the things I'm interested in is that Dr. Sarah Cheyette talked about headaches and ADHD.
Yes, I saw that.
Yes, and I was unaware that migraine headaches and ADHD can be can correlate.
I knew it.
And yeah. I'm not surprised. And they may or may not be hormonally related migraines because migraines can be hormonally related, which I didn't realize until I talked to Sarah about that. Another person that I was really excited to have on, and I've been wanting to talk about this for a long time. Is I want to talk about genetics and ADHD.
Yes.
And I belong to a professional organization where all those top names that we mentioned, the Russell Barclays and the people who do the seminal research, the original research, they are at the front of the room. I'm sitting at the back of the room trying to drink it in, you know, trying to keep my fingers on, hold on for dear life. And yet I was thrilled when I approached Dr. Steve Ferrone to talk about research in genetics because he has done that research. So I was so thrilled to talk to him. It's a short, sweet session, but it is so full of information that I think people will really be eager to know, especially for those of us who deal with family members, friends, you know, relatives who say, oh, ADHD, you're just making that up. It's just try harder. There's interestingly enough, there are now genetic correlations between ADHD and obesity, ADHD and BMI, ADHD and heart disease, ADHD and lung cancer. Isn't that genetically now? I'm not saying that this is just kind of like, oh, well, just because, but it's genetic links. And I don't want to say just because you have ADHD, you're going to have those things.
Right.
Genetics are a one piece of the puzzle. Our nature versus nurture. Nurture has a lot to do with this as well. So I'm really, really excited about those. And there are so many more. You know, last year, we are talking about pregnancy for the first time this year.
I saw that, Dusty. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And Dusty and I have been trying to connect for a couple of years. But let's face it. Pregnancy, men don't have those issues.
No.
And if you're pregnant, if you're a woman or someone who identifies as a woman who can be pregnant, very, very interesting conversation. And of course we talk about some of the things that everyone talks about, because how do we get things done? And what do we do for productivity? And what about medications? And what about a planner, et cetera? But another thing that we have never talked about is what some people are calling the ADHD tax.
Yeah.
The amount of money that it costs, and it's not just money, it's burden of ADHD on us. Yeah. When I wrote my book, I decided, I didn't call it that because no one had come up with that term and I certainly didn't.
Yeah.
But when I wrote my book all those many years ago, I sat down and tried to figure out how much ADHD had cost me just in the time that I had known about it. And when I added up the cost of doctor's appointments, things that I'd signed up for that I didn't ever do, showed up for, classes I'd missed, late fees, tax things that I had, you know, screwed up on, all of these things that when I'm skating in at the last minute, I don't get the early bird special kind of thing, you know, all those things shockingly added up to about $250,000 over the year. Yeah.
I believe it.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Especially when you get lost income. I look at the trajectory of my career and all of these opportunities I missed. And it's incredible.
I agree. And I just want to mention one more thing that we're doing this year that I haven't really talked about much. In fact, I haven't mentioned it to anyone but you. Mike Fidel is an ADHD coach, and he has offered to do a live improv class for us on Thursday evening from 7 to 8:15. That's Eastern time. So everyone's invited. He can't do improv with everyone, but he's going to work with three or four people at a time. And his experience shows that improv can actually bring more focus and more attention for ADHD folks. So I'm really, really, really jazzed about that. I'm really excited about that. So
that is awesome.
I know. And then of course the pink ticket affair or the pink ticket party that we talk about is on Saturday afternoon. And I will say, because remember when I said that I really wanted to create a women's conference, a live conference, so we could be with each other and talk to each other. That was the whole reason I created the AD Diva Network. I was determined we're just not going to sit here and have experts pour information into you. We need to talk about it.
Yeah.
And there's nothing wrong with experts. We need them. I'm one of them, for heaven's sake, but we need to talk to each other. So the pink ticket was something that I was saying, we're not doing this unless we have an opportunity for live and an interactive session. And so we have 3 hours set aside. We're inviting some of our experts in to answer questions. So you can ask questions live, because that's the other thing with somebody's just giving you information, you don't have an opportunity to ask them questions.
Right.
And then we're going to do breakout rooms in Zoom, because everybody's familiar with Zoom now.
Yeah.
We're going to do breakout rooms, and I will send a topic out so that that everyone can talk about that same topic. But you know, ADHD, I'm not going to talk about what I say to talk about, which is perfect. I just want to give women an opportunity to connect with each other and say, this is me. And they can, of course, have their cameras on if they choose to, or they can call in, or they can leave their cameras off. They don't have to be seen. It's not something that you have to dress up for. This is come as you are. This is ADHD, guys. So we want to make this as comfortable as possible. So I'm really excited about that too. That costs a little extra money. And for a lot of people, that $50 is maybe the best money they spend all year, because it's the only time that they actually are able to talk to other women and actually ask questions of experts one-on-one instead of just kind of out there in the wilderness. And I don't know about you, but I had a lot of questions and no one was really helping me answer them.
Nope.
Even my psychiatrist was kind of like, here's a pill.
Here's a brochure, and there's going to be nothing in there that's helpful to you.
Exactly. Well, and they're so general.
Right.
And we're all so different. You know, our ADHD manifests in such different ways. There's a psychiatrist in Toronto who took, back in the day of the DSM-4, he took all of the descriptors of ADHD and he cross-referenced them so that every combination and permutation of those words and those descriptors, he came up with a total of 7,000 potential different ADHD variations. Yeah.
Wow.
And that's before, and first of all, that's DSM-4, and probably 5 would be even more, but that's before we add in gender. It's before we add in socioeconomic. It's before we add in education. It's before we add in culture, experience, familial issues, all those things, genetics. So you can imagine that each of us are, you know, like a little snowflake. You know, we really are unique. It's almost our fingerprint is of our ADHD, even though we have some common traits.
Yeah, I use the fingerprint thing a lot. I was telling my dad about my podcast, and he said, how are you going to keep that going? Like, aren't you going to run out of ideas? I said, every single person I talk to, it's like a fingerprint. I could ask identical questions to every single person, and it's a fascinating episode because we are all so different, you know. So I love the fingerprint analogy. Where can we go if we want to learn more about the Palooza?
Thanks for asking. Well, if you want to find out more about me, it's addiva.net, ADDIVA, and it is AD Diva because even though we are not divas in the traditional sense of being arrogant and, you know, have to have everything my way, we need our things to be our way because otherwise we're, don't move my piles. Don't touch my piles, Diva. Yeah. Anyway, that's the reason I said AD Diva. For the ADHD Palooza, and you can get there, you can get to the Palooza from AD Diva, but the, it's easy to just type in ADHDpalooza.com. And I have all the misspellings of Palooza, so don't worry if you misspell it, but it does have two O's and a Z, just so you know. And then there are two Paloozas. We have the Women's Palooza that happens in the early spring and probably will back up to February next year. We just had some COVID issues this year. Yeah. But the Parents Palooza, the ADHD Parents Palooza happens in the summertime. Okay. And I plan that with Impact ADHD, or now they've changed their name to Impact Parents, with Diane Dempster and Elaine Taylor Klaus, who are experts in ADHD parenting. So if you have kiddos with ADHD, and you may have ADHD yourself, for heaven's sake, that's a great place to get information. It's a completely different set of experts. And just between you, me, and all of your listeners, I am planning to create an ADHD couples palooza and eventually an ADHD entrepreneurs palooza as well. So there are things coming. They're on the horizon. If I could just clone myself, they would happen.
Absolutely.
Or maybe if I didn't have ADHD.
I prefer the cloning. We need more of
you. Good, thanks. Me too.
Awesome. Well, Linda, thank you so much. And it's great to finally meet you. And really looking forward to the Palooza. Thank you so much for the work you do for us. Mm-hmm. And I can't wait. So
yeah, me too. I'm excited. Monday, March 8th.
Yes, it's right around the corner, you guys. It's coming right up. I'm going to turn this around hopefully today while I'm in the car. We're driving to the beach, but I'm going to...
Oh, wow, the beach. The beach. All right. And just so your folks know, if they've been to Paloozas before, this is a little different. We're not releasing them at scheduled times. We have recorded all of them. We are going to give them to you in a nice bouquet at the beginning of the day, at least 7 o'clock Eastern time. So you can watch them anytime you want to. You've got them free for 24 hours. At 7 o'clock the next day, we're going to give you another bundle of wonderful, and they're divided by days on our website. So you'll know who the people are going to be. And of course I'll put them in social media as well.
Yeah.
But I just wanted to let people know that if you really want to watch the headache one, for instance, then just look on the day that it is and make sure that you grab that one that day. And they'll all be in Palooza Central. So we have, perfect. I thought it was so sweet because there was a woman who signed up for the Palooza. She said, I signed up 2 or 3 weeks ago and I'm so disappointed because I keep clicking on the Palooza Central and nothing allows me to see anything. And we had to gently tell her, it doesn't start till next week.
Yeah, that sounds like something I would do. Yep, I get it.
All right. I'm sorry for that long postscript, but I'm glad I got
it. I love it. And that's such a great feature because I am the type of person who, I don't know when I'm going to get interrupted. I want to see like what I want to see immediately. So.
And then you can put it on pause and you can watch it when you have another minute or two. Yeah. So it works out really well, I think. I'm keeping my fingers crossed that people are going to appreciate it. I've borrowed the idea from some of my ADHD colleagues like Lori Dupar, but it may or may not work. Some people may love it. Some people may hate it. So we'll just have to see. I'm looking for feedback. We're open to everything.
It's a learning process. Well, thank you again.
Thank you. Take care. Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. All right.
That went great.